Here we have the Focal Integration Golf 6 Integration Kit, which I told you about in a previous video. We have some tweeters. Nice looking tweeters. The nice rough cone focals that I like, much like the polyglass style. Comes with its own serial number ticket. Really heavy. A lot of weight to these. Really big magnet. Really big crossovers there. Factory fit, hopefully. The best thing about this kit is really the details they go to. You get your own panel popper. I've never had one of those. They even include the long Allen wrench to make sure you can get to the door spots. They include the drill bit for drilling out your rivets, and they include new rivets and a bunch of new door panel clips. Because from experience, you always break one or two of these, especially the first time you take your door panels off. So this is an extra nice touch here too. That's why this kit is so complete. It has everything you need. I'm going to start by removing the door panel. I'll do driver's side. I'm not going to do a whole how-to on this. I have a previous video, you'll have to find it, from one of my GTI years that shows how to remove the panels. I can just tell you that you're going to remove this piece here in front to get to the three torques. And the two door, actually this one might have a bolt down here also, and I'm going to get this door panel off. I got it. Of course it's nerve-wracking because it pulls so hard. I didn't break any of these clips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clips kind of go in these holes. Actually, it's a little U-shape that goes over these little ridges. So it snaps in. Remember in my previous video, at the back here, it's like a fork that slides in from the back first. So don't pry here and pull off. You're going to snap these little forks off. So to reassemble, you slide in, then snap everything in from bottom to top. Then you will have 1, 2, 3. And 4 torque screws. Your two door might have different positions, so make sure you check underneath before pulling too hard. I'm gonna get these 4 screws out and then I'll continue. By the way, this Allen is a really nice touch. A lot of times people will have a torque socket. Sometimes you can't fit it in some of these holes, so the long Allen is needed. I thought I might have to go buy one. Also note that the bottom bolt is a real funny screw. The other ones are standard. This bottom one has a big lip, so you know where this goes. Next, you're going to pop. This is a nerve-wracking spot. This is how you break clips and stuff. You got to try and get your fingertips just under it. It hurts. Maybe I can try the tool too. You got to just pull. I mean, there's nothing else you can do. And wait for it to pop, and you're going to be afraid it's going to break. So as you can see, this is insane and I'm super scared, but that's why they give you new clips. I got it off. You can see how much energy that took. It's really stiff. I did just roll down my window just to make it easier to pull this out. Next, as you can imagine, you're basically just going to start unplugging all the harnesses you can find. I'm going to need some screws for these. Door cable. Gotta refresh on how to do that. I'll get back to you in a sec. One thing you do need is your rivet gun. I've had this one quite a while. Let's see if we can pop that tweet out. It's just 3 clips on the bottom and a round clip on the top. Okay. Good. One clip stayed in. I'm very carefully gonna take that off without breaking it. With this cool tool, it's a fork.
Well,
I'm gonna do that myself carefully. I don't wanna force it right now. And there's your first tweet out. Next, what you do, you're going to peel this piece off. It's supposed to be in the door. It always comes out with your tweeter. You're gonna put it back in the hole in the door. Make sure you get every little leg in there. Don't leave any legs sticking out. And that's your first pot. Then you're gonna transfer these two little clips to the new tweeter. Look at the difference in those. Wow. It has curves. It's sexy, it's wavy. Looks a lot better than that big old screen. You got a nice tweet there. Really nice piece. Looks really good. In case anybody needs the part number for your stock tweet someday, maybe you can see it there. What I did was I peeled off this foam backing. This isn't going to fit on the new one, I don't think. I'll make sure, but I don't think you use it with the new one. Next, you're going to see if we can replace this tweet. Wire goes under here, under there, tuck up on the seal here. This one could go under this little seal. To make sure you get this top lip in the channel. It's tough to get in. Oh, and you keep pushing, it really goes deep. You gotta be gentle, of course, you don't wanna crack it. But it took a lot of pressure. It's seated in real nice. The bottom, I'm gonna look at this bottom seal, maybe fix it a little bit, but that's pretty much how you pop it in. Naturally, you're gonna be very careful with this next step. Drilling out these rivets. Nice sharp drill bit should work well. No reason to go fast. Popped off one. A little cap is what it pops off if you haven't dealt with these before. Then you'll see the rest of it once we take the speaker out. Forgot here. Get this out of the way before I forget. Tuck in the speaker harness for later. There's the next cap. This can get stuck on your drill. Be careful. Third cap. Cut your hand up. These things are sharp too, the sheared metal. I saw them, sometimes they'll get stuck. Dump out the shavings there. Let me show you the speakers in a sec. You got them right here. You got your factory plugs. The new speaker is, of course, deeper. Oh, much deeper in the magnet side too. See that? Much bigger magnet, which is good. These say 4 ohm, the stalkers. These don't say anything, but of course they are made for this, so they should be good. Something very interesting here. This OEM sub doesn't have any crossovers on it. And the focal, of course, has the huge capacitors, whatever you call them here, for frequency. I don't remember what the 10 is, but it's probably like 100 cutoff or something. Wouldn't mind if it was maybe 90, would be a little better. But that's interesting that the stock one doesn't have the crossovers. The new one does. That could provide a little base protection on these. I'll give you another tip on these. These can be real tricky to get out the back. The 6 has this little basket frame. I don't know if I remember that. I don't think I've had these Mark 6 doors speakers out before. But you can't get in behind it here to hold it. And I took my pliers here. I crushed the edges a little bit so I can push it through the back. And you gotta just get your fingers in there to catch them. You can use a magnet if you drop one, but best case, you wanna catch them right in your finger. Just go really slow. Okay, these bottom ones are super hard because you have a lot of room on top. The bottom ones, you can't even get your finger behind there. I pushed it through. You can see it down there. You just take a magnet. And just work your way out. This is a two-hand job. Got it. Tougher install than it looks. They even come with a couple extra rivets, which is another nice tip. So your wire's on the outside. You don't need to worry about that. You're going to take your rivet gun. You're going to slide it in like that. I'm actually going to change my bit. I'll be right back. And again, slide your bit in there. The key with rivets, you don't want to end the bottom of your stroke right at the snap point in case you might lose tension at just the wrong time. Then you got to drill it out and start over. You want to cinch it up. It's going to get tighter and tighter. And you kind of pump it. This is a two-hand operation, sorry. Had a bit of a mishap where that bit I changed was actually too small and I got my leftover shaft stuck in there. It took me like 10 minutes to get it free. So I went with my bigger shaft so it's not so firm in there. And put it in here. Pump it. Ratchets up at the back. See what I'm saying? Just do a little bit until it's close, then do your full snap. Breaks off clean. It's tricky though. Finally, you snap your plug back in, get the car back together. You've already done it, but you hang your door into a little ridge at the top, then you got 3 and 3, inside and out. Pop, 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 pop. Now we do our 4 screws and we're pretty much done. That's the focal install. I'm gonna get through the other side a lot quicker. It's a nice looking tweet. So the first side took me a good hour. The second side took me maybe 15 minutes. So once you learn it, it's real good. I did actually break a couple clips. I wouldn't say break, but they're supposed to be wide like that. One on each door. So I used 2 of the 4 they supplied. Killer touch, or I would have been screwed.